Hallo und herzlich willkommen auf unserem heutigen Flug von Beirut nach Doha. Wir fliegen heute in der Inibuilds A300 und unsere geplante Flugzeit wird etwa 2 Stunden 15 Minuten betragen. A very warm welcome to everybody. We are currently located in Beirut. By the way, this is a freeware scenery and we are now flying from Beirut to Doha in this beautiful Airbus A300 from Inibuilds in the livery of Qatar Airways Cargo. So yeah, where we get loaded with our cargo's equipment, I would say we directly jump into the cockpit and get started. So first of all, let's power up the aircraft. Batteries 1, 2 and 3 are online. Switching on the APU, the external power unit. Okay, fine so far. Okay, so we're having that. Let's switch on the nav lights, the beacon lights. Okay, all right. Switching on the IRS. Okay, now I have to find the company route. So it's basically Lima Bravo Alpha to Oscar Tango Hotel Motel. Oscar Lima Bravo Alpha to Oscar Tango Hotel. Hotel. Yeah, that's the route. Let's align the IRS. The flight number today is QR2020. QR2020. The cross index is 35. The flight level is 35,000 feet. Okay, that's good so far. I'm switching to the fuel panel. Okay, we need total fuel of 18,000 100
kg. Sorry.
That was a little bit too much clear. Sorry. Sorry, my bad. So we are taking dot one. Yeah, perfect. So, all right. Load fuel. All right. And how much payload do we have? 35 tons. Next, okay. Load. Okay, let's load the aircraft. Now we go to the FMS again. Wait, that's what I'm looking for. Sorry, I want to choose the SIDAD star. We are going to depart from runway 21, and our departure route will be LEBOR 1 Delta, and then back to the flight plan. That's good. And then we're going to take the arriving route. So we are going to arrive at 16 left, taking the ILS approach via 1 Mike. And insert. Let's check for this corner. So no issues here. Looks good so far. Going back to the init page. Send. Okay, we are departing from OLBA. Request ATIS. Hope this is working. Okay, looks good so far. Okay, air condition will be on. Flex, okay. This is the standard configuration. Great. This looks also good. Our block fuel is 18 tons. This is right. Okay, great. I'll just quickly go back to the ground performance, to the load sheet. So, is 130 tons. Oh, sorry. My bad. All right. Center of gravity. 29.9. Request again. And send to FMS. All right. So flex temperature 36. Okay. Yeah, good. At this point. All right. Let's continue to power up. So the flight controls are basically here to set on. Then we are going to start the APU, so we switched on our pumps. Let's go back to this one. I hope this is the right one. Okay, so fire test before we start the APU. Alright. All right, works. So we have many smoke detectors because we are a cargo plane, so we have to switch that on as well. Okay, probably can be switched on. And then going back to the APU. Our flex temperature is 36, so we can set that. Flex 2, okay, that's great. Okay, we can get rid of the ground equipment. Going back to the flight operations, ground ops, ground services. We don't need the fuel truck anymore. We don't need this one. We don't need the stairs. And we don't need the air starter unit anymore. So available. Perfect. So the APU is available. Okay, so the APU generator is on. Perfect. Emergency lights on. So APU bleed is on. And we just need the aircon flow. All right. So this is running. So the APU is running as well. This looks good so far. We can extend the landing lights. and we are getting rid of the ground power and the chokes. All right, so it's the ILS aligned. Should be right. So those marking kickers standby. Okay. Let's go to the ground frequency. We are on the ground frequency. Quick look on the charts airport. So we are departing from this here. It's fine. Let's plan the pushback. Pushback, pushback, pushback. It's over there.
Sound a cockpit plan acknowledged. Call me through the menu when you are ready.
And we are ready.
Sound a cockpit. Tow is driving up.
So unfortunately, we have some rain. Alright, so then let's set the altitude. First of all, 5,000 feet. Let me set 250 knots just in case. What is our V2?
Okay, all doors and hatches are closed. Ready to connect.
Back to the performance page, takeoff performance, V2 is 100. Alright, doing this. Alright. FU is running, good so far. All right, we are good to start the engine. Starting engine 2. So, perfect. Unfortunately, we have bad weather, and like I said, guys, X-Plane is struggling with clouds and so on. It's a little bit bad. So basically with rainy weather, so we have a thunderstorm here near Beirut. But yeah, I'm quite happy with now the clouds here over there. Okay, this is working. So engine 2 is basically available. Let's start the number 2. Set.
Disconnecting tail, stand by.
Okay, looks good so far. Engine mode selector on. Right. So let's set the flaps. Flaps 15. Set. Trim 0.6 down. Right. Flight controls. Where is flight controls? It's over there. Right, so we're a little bit struggling with the...
Tow is disconnected and bypass bin has been removed.
0.6 down, right? So, flight control check. Full up. Full down. Full left. Full right. Rudder full left. Neutral. Rudder full right. Neutral. Okay. We have that. Hey Lucas, glad you joined. Thanks for joining. I'm fine. Yeah, thank you. So basically the scenery is the Beirut scenery from, I think it's the very popular one. Not sure how the developer is called, so, but you find it on the Explained forum. It's an amazing scenery. They made the airport, they made this whole city of Beirut. So let me quickly check the route. Maybe we're flying over the city. It might be that we fly over the city, so it's an amazing scenery. And the weather is basically the, what do you call it, ultra weather XP. So I basically own the previous version and I saw there's a possibility to upgrade it. So yeah, right, I did that. So let's see, yeah, the generators are on. And yeah, we installed it, so yeah. Quite happy with that. So let's get rid of the view. Beacon lights are on. The taxi lights are on. So let's quickly taxi to the runway. Yeah, like I said, unfortunately low FPS now due to this heavy weather. Now we have a thunderstorm here in Beirut. As we all know, it's been kind of handy weather. let me just quickly set their vertical speed, 2000. Oh, let's do it like that. All right. And Lucas, how are you? I hope you are doing fantastic. Glad you joined. Okay. So, all right. This is set. We have to set the navigation. We will set the auto throttle later, sorry. We are setting. So yeah guys, a very warm welcome to everybody. As you can see, we are good to take off. We are just turning on the runway. I'm quite sorry for this low FPS, but yeah, the explain is just a little bit difficult when it comes to weather. So we set the flex temperature, we had set the navigation profile. So, first of all, we need to set the transponder to 22NT, our favorite. Flight numbers, so we have that. This is done. Brake to max. Okay, we're good for a rejected takeoff. Strobe lights on. Okay. yes, it's a 3-hour, 15-minute flight, but well, Navigraph said it's a little bit faster, so let's hope. And yeah, like I said, so basically this is a freeware scenery made by a great developer team. You find it on Explain forum. The weather is Ultra Weather XP, so I reinstalled it after I upgraded it. Okay.
On runway 21.
There we are on the runway. Afraid of this weather. Here we go. rotate. Okay, positive climb, gear up. Autopilot one on. Okay. We're climbing. Auto throttle activated profile. So I keep. Let's ignition on. And what we definitely need now is to switch off the runway turn off lights and the nose lights. Alright. The window heating is on, that's great. Probe heat is on. And we're switching on the engine anti-ice, and we're switching on the wing anti-ice, because we're flying through the rain. And flaps up. Increasing. 50,000 feet. Okay. So this is running. Okay. The auto brake is deactivated. Right. We can deactivate the ground spoilers. And we can enjoy the nice view over Beirut. That's awesome, guys. Enjoy this. Here over there is a stadium. Unfortunately, we have bad weather. So we are flying through the clouds now. But over there you see downtown. Beirut downtown. Look at this. I mean, this is just an amazing scenery. So I hope you guys also enjoy that. Even flying through this. Extremely bad weather. Whew, man. Right, there we are. Okay, 10,000 feet is passed. That's great. Let's switch off this one. Switching off the ignition because there's no rain anymore. And this is also set. Great. Hey, welcome, Falcon Aviation. Glad you joined. How are you doing? So I guess we're still over Beirut.
Yeah.
Okay, let's cool down a little bit the compartments. Don't to heat up too much. Alright. We we continue our climb to the final flight level. Now this is sometimes a little bit annoying with these kick spots, so so yeah, right, 35,000 feet. Look at that. Yeah, thanks. I'm also good. Glad you guys joined. Tracking the landing lights. We can switch that off as well. Okay. Alright. Changing range. Perfect. So this looks good so far. Okay, tautomizing range, maybe we should keep the RTIs on. That looks good so far. So, alright, let me get Avitab open. Where is it? Okay. So, alright guys. So, we departed here. Currently now flying over Syria, then crossing Iraq, and then flying here, this corner. Right? So, here flying, wait, sorry, here. Flying over Baghdad, and then over there, flying over Basra, flying here, near to Kuwait City. Then we keep going to Qatar. So basically, it's on the side, we're flying here, back here to Qatar City. Right. We start our descent basically over there. So yeah, looks like a promising flight. So we expect on flight time from now about 2 hours. Yeah, it's going to be this one, and then we need, sorry, the approach ILS, cap 3, alright. So what we can do now, we already can set the ILS frequency, for our approach for our runway, 16 left. You can see here is 108.7 and it's 156 degrees, so we can set it over there. Come on now. 56. Yeah, there it is. Do we have a viewer there? Yeah, there's the Doha viewer. We also can set the Doha viewer frequency. Okay, I have to figure out how this works. Can't set it now, but we keep that in mind. Right. Great. Yeah, I saw that you rebranded. Good choice. I'm just using, to be quite honest, a really cheap one. Let me double check. I just got it on Amazon. Let me double check. How is it called? It's really a cheap one, so nothing fancy. It's called the EKSA E900. Costs me around 26 euros, so yeah, I'm quite happy with it, so so the autopilot is following the course. That's basically what we want, right? So wait, I'm sending you a picture, or maybe a link in the Discord, and you can see which I'm using. I mean, you guys have to do your own choice when you are looking for something, but and I don't want to advert something, so this is why I don't send it here. And you are basically on my Discord, so I'll just give you a link there. Great. Glad you got it. Yeah, no worries, mate. See you later. So, yeah. So now we are flying in the dark. Sorry, guys. You can't see much here. Yeah, well, basically my language. Just Google for the name of it. I mean, the product name should be the same. Okay, guys, I can't wait to have this passenger version to make a nice long-haul flight with this, so this is definitely fun. Even if I totally have to admit that I totally don't understand the autopilot. I will have a quick look on it. Didn't got your message on Discord, mate.
Okay.
Okay, all right. So that looks fine. Mode. Let's see whether we can increase the speed by changing the mode. Nope. Cost index. Yeah, okay, it's over there. So maybe we can change it on this init page. Reference. Nope. Arcas. What is the Arcas doing? Let's get the wind request. It seems I can't change. It seems I can't change the hey, welcome, Mr. Kilabani. Glad you joined. Oh, yeah. All right, I got it. Yeah, this also looks good. I mean, usually you can trust the ratings, I guess, so when it has good ratings, maybe you can look after some reviews on the internet or something like that, you know?
Yeah,
Oh, I have a small problem with my with my settings now. Sorry, my fault. Now it should work.
Yeah.
This is weird. Okay, yeah, sometimes technique is doing weird stuff, man. So yeah, guys, I hope you enjoyed the stream so far. So let's have a quick look in the cabin. It's not a big one, so don't expect too much because it's a cargo airplane. I'm going to be a little bit confused what I see here. Basically, I don't see not what I want to do. So. So over here we have a control panel for the lights in this cargo room. So
look.
Yeah. Right. So yeah, this is basically what we have. So this is basically the cabin. And quick look here. Alright, so here's our freight, and here's the cargo door that is currently, like you can see, locked, so not much to see anymore. So let's lock the cockpit door again. Yeah, okay. we are currently flying over the desert in Iraq, so yeah. And we expect our landing in about 1 hour, maybe 1 hour 30 minutes. Okay, so we have ATIS, that's great. And currently 25% of the flight is done. So guys, I hope you are not getting irritated with me when I change the timing of the day. Because I don't want to have a night landing. And I want to try out my new plugin here. So basically, I'm owning Ultra Weather XP since a few years, but then I decided to leave the Orc forum or the Orc platform, so that's why I never upgraded it to the next version, what I did yesterday. So. And I'm quite happy with the lightning here. And it's looking a little bit more colorful and more realistic from the sunrise perspective and from the perspective you see a yeah, the sunset as well, so Yeah, welcome back. Welcome back. So yeah, that's the Airbus A300. Okay, let's check the engine page. Looks good so far. Hydraulics looks also good. Electricity works. Okay. Bleeder works. So basically we can so go back to the condition side. Looks good so far. Cabin press, good. So fuel, we have still enough fuel. Our flight, APUs off, flight controls, great, doors are closed, and the wheels looking good. So perfect. That's definitely a bright sunrise. Glad you joined, mate. Wish you a good night, and hope to see you soon. Thanks for joining. I really appreciate your support. Thanks a lot. Good night. So guys, I might just switch off my microphone for a few minutes. But I'm on the chat and yeah, just keep texting and I will reply. I am just switching off my microphone for a few minutes because I'm just making a coffee for myself and yeah, so just keep texting, I will be all right back, so no, hope you don't mind guys. While I'm making my coffee, you guys enjoy the sunrise. Hallo zu Lunai, schön, dass du da bist. Ich hoffe, dir gefällt das Team. Zu Lunai, ich fürchte, EasyJet Miami Dortmund wird schwierig, da das ein Longhaul ist und dementsprechend stehen die Chancen schlecht, dass du das mit einem Narrowbody schaffst. Also, das ist eher unrealistisch. So I would say this is definitely a really beautiful sunrise. Okay guys, as I said, please enjoy the sunrise. I'm just making myself a coffee. We'll be right back on the microphone in a few minutes.
Flight 9742, heading 270 intercept, cleared ILS approach runway 23 and speed 170 knots.
Speed 170, Detroit, cleared ILS 23, flight 9742.
Encore 3573, arrival descend 8000 for runway 23.
Yeah, thanks Lucas. I switched the timing to the sunrise, so because I wanted to check out my new plugin. As I said, I just upgraded Ultra Weather XP, and I'm quite happy with the result. So, yeah. So it's definitely looking beautiful and much more colorful than the stock version from X-Plane. And I'm owning Ultra Weather XP since a few years, but I didn't upgrade it, so I just did this yesterday night, and so this is the first try since I upgraded that, so yeah, I'm quite happy with that. So yeah, quite happy with that. So basically now we are shortly before Baghdad, so we are currently over Iraq. Yeah, so
candidate 1237 left 7270 intercept, cleared visual approach, runway 248.
want that at Mirage for the pitch?
Negative.
Delta November, Alpha, turn right, heading 150.
Right, 150. Jordan 7246, heading 270, intercept. Individual approach for 24 right, speed 170 left.
Heading 270, approach to clear your approach runway 24 right, visual, and speed 170 knots, clear 7246.
Vehicle 7545, descend 3000, pass 3, speed 100 knots.
Pass 3000, speed 3190 knots, descend 5%.
Vehicle 7545, turn left heading 330.
Left heading 330, make 7545.
Alright, I'm back, guys. Just got a quick coffee, so yeah, let's check where we're going to be located. So yeah, we are just, as you can see here, we are near Baghdad, so it should be on the left-hand side. Can't see from this perspective, I guess, so it's a little bit dusty outside. Okay, so let's see. That looks good so far. Yeah, right, we are crossing Baghdad on the left-hand side. Continue flying next to Basra, then Kuwait City, and you're right, then later we are going to descend near Bahrain, so yeah, great. So we have still 1 hour and 10 minutes left. Means we start our descent in about 50 minutes. right. Archives wind data received. Great. Let me see what wind data is. Return. Let's see what they also have. So we have sensors here. Seems they are working. So GPS altitude is basically the same altitude like here. That's great. So let's go back. Position monitoring. Looks fine. Going back to the airport. Distance, great. Inner page, okay, I hope we're going to see something there. Aircraft status. Oh, what is this? Definitely something weird. Hello, SimPilot. Welcome to the stream. Glad you are here. Glad you joined. I hope you're doing well and fantastic. So, yeah, nice to have you. We are flying in this Airbus A300 from Beirut to Doha. And we have a good hour to fly. Crossing here, Kuwait City, and we're going to arrive over there. Oh, let's have a quick look out of the window. So, do you guys have any questions for this jet? Just keep asking and I try to let you know what I think about it. So, let's switch on here some lights. Okay, this is a very cool feature. Can we change the range of the TCAS? Quite hard to say. Can't see any opportunity to change it here. And there's no knob on it, right? Or maybe. Okay, well, 6 nautical miles should be enough. SimPilot, I don't own the 727. I think from all the airliners, I just have the A300 and the Concorde. So, and I would say the Concorde is a little bit like the generation of the 727, a little bit later, but from the navigation perspective, I'm a little bit concerned about the navigation system because they don't use those modern navigation systems, and for me personally it's a little bit tough to understand how it works, right? Tricky, and This is why I never bought a 727, and I usually, to be quite honest, fly more than LNS. I don't know why I got myself the A300, but I quite like the way of modern avionics, or a little bit like a mixture, and the 727 don't have anything modern at this point, so I would fly the 737-200, so a little bit later. So, but I don't own the 727, and but an aircraft I definitely want to get is the 737-200, so the really, really classic one, and I think this is kind of cool. But I mean, as you guys know, flight simulation is a really, really expensive hobby, and the add-ons are quite expensive, so I'm currently looking forward to the McDonnell Douglas MD-11, or next year maybe the BAE-146 that is currently developed by Justin, right? And yeah, so I'm a little bit saving for what is upcoming in the next year. So I hope, yeah, we see new aircrafts next year. I'm a little bit disappointed that we don't have an Airbus A380 yet, so this is a little bit concerning me. It would take so long to develop one. Yeah, and what else I'm looking forward to? Not sure what else is coming, quite honest. But what about you, Simpilot? What do you fly? What do you prefer to fly? Do you own the 727? Maybe you can tell us more about it. Look on the charts again. So we're going to intercept the ILS on 3,000 feet. That's great. Transition altitude is 13,000 feet. Good to know. So the air elevation is 13 feet. We have no obstacles that are higher than 500 feet. That's great. So the decision height is 100 feet. That's good. Okay, let's have a quick look here. So we are arriving from... Good question. From where are we arriving? I guess from here somewhere. To Van. Not from there. We are going to arrive from here, 12,000 feet. Descending to 8,000, going to Ivani. Quick look here. So, whether it's Bayan, yeah. Astim, alright. Engu, yeah. Ivani to Tovan. And then we should continue with the ILS approach. Tovan, yeah, 3,000. Alright. That should be fine. Looks good. So this seems to work. Oh, that's cool. I didn't know that you can turn off the default FMC in the settings. That's good to know, so maybe in this case it's easier for me to fly, because the OLBA avionics are kind of complicated, I guess. So this navigation system of the OLBA jets is really, really complicated, so this will make it much easier for me to fly this aircraft, right? Very good to know. Thanks for the information, Sunpilot. So, what's your favorite aircraft? Still flying over Iraq. Do we have some? Oh, we just have ground and approach. Should I take this one? Hey, welcome, Bonan. Thank you, highly appreciate that. So yeah, I quite like this jet, so I like flying with it once in a while, so... And thanks for your support, this is really, really highly appreciated. Okay, great, Sunpilot, that's good to know. So, well, then you know the 727 really, really well. Okay, so we have that. We have the performance page. Quick check on the route, so still over IREC, but we expect our descent in about maybe 30 minutes. That should be fine. Okay, so we have that.
37261, right here to go.
South Papa Mike, descend 8,000.
8,000, South Papa Mike.
Stand by. First air transat 357, turn left 7270 intercept. Your official approach, runway 248.
So good news, 56% of the flight is done, so just about 30
arrival
minutes left till the descent, but shouldn't be that bad. Just doing a short system check. No issues with the engine. No hydraulic issues. Electricity systems are working fine. Bleeder looks good. Air condition works well. Cabin press. Given that the altitude is 6,800 straight so far, we have about 10 tons of fuel left. That's great. No issues with the wheels, doors are closed, that should be right. So the flight controls, no issues, and the AV is off. So going back on this page. Right. If anybody of you knows how to set this one, cause when I'm... Oh, okay, got it. Issue solved. I couldn't set the VOR frequency, so but now I know how it works. So I want to set the Doha VOR. Right. That looks good. 44 ILS frequency set. And this is also set, great. So yeah, basically everything's set for the approach. So descending at the waypoint, we have a quick look. Waypoint. Oh, sorry, wrong direction. 35. So we are leaving our altitude beyond VLOC. Yeah, welcome Wave Gaming. Why am I supposed to click F7? Not sure what's going to happen then, but what X-Rain taught me is never change your running system, so I don't think I'm doing that now.
Russia 1175, turn left to 330, descend 3000. Left heading 330, descend 3000, west left. Jet 520, hold the speed 170 knots to NOAA. Make contact power there, 118.35.
Guys, let me know which kind of view you prefer. Alright, so yeah, guys, I hope you're fine. So we have a straight line ahead. We expect good weather. So approach. The approach on 44 looks great. Okay. So yeah, I can't wait to till we descend. Okay, guys, I hope you guys don't mind. I will quickly have a coffee, so I just will be available on the chat. But I don't speak on my mic, so I don't want you guys to hear me drinking coffee, so that's why I just switch off the microphone for a few minutes and will be right back. So please don't mind, I just need another coffee and will be on the microphone back in a few minutes, and will definitely reply on the chat, so the voice.
Traffic at your 1/3 position about 10 miles northwestbound is a citation.
for the Herzlich Willkommen. Schön, dass du da bist. Ich hoffe, dir geht es gut und ja, ich freue mich auf jeden Fall, dass du in den Stream gefunden hast. Wir sind noch gute 20 Minuten schätzungsweise vom Top of Descent entfernt und unsere Gesamtflugzeit sollte bei noch etwa 40 Minuten gehen. Von daher genau der richtige Zeitpunkt, um einzuschalten. Schön, dass du da bist. So the last parts, as you can see here, shouldn't be that long, so and it's back to good weather in Doha, so yeah, can't wait for the landing. Alles klar, Vorsicht. Ich freue mich drauf und dann sehen wir uns gleich wieder. Wie gesagt, bis zur Landung dürfte es noch maximal 35 bis 40 Minuten dauern. Okay, this is interesting. We can't move this window, I don't know why. Also not movable. Okay, interesting. Oh yeah, we are close. No, closer, not close. Closer to top of descent, so in about 160 miles we reach our top of descent. Schauen wir mal ganz kurz die Meter für Doha an. Current flight. Okay, QNH ist 10:16. Wind 350 und 7 Knoten. Temperatur 20 Grad and no significant changes. Okay, das klingt doch schon mal ganz gut. Okay, dann rüber zu Jeddah Center. Okay, I can't see the traffic even if the TCAS says there's traffic, so let's keep it for a moment for that. Or maybe the scale is wrong. was it saying 6 nautical miles, but let's see. Any changes here, so... Okay. Climbed 200 feet over our cruising level, but anyway, we are going to fix that now. So 20 minutes left. So, wir können schon mal die Flughöhe für den Sinkflug einstellen. 12.000 Fuß erstmal. I'm just setting the descending altitude to 12,000 feet. And then we keep adjusting it while we monitor the descent. Drop descent is 60 miles ahead. Okay, so we should get ready for descent. Okay. Over there is Bahrain. Okay, changing to Bahrain Center. Okay, let's start our descent now. Okay, flight level change. Okay, great, so we are descending now.
Toronto 30, 938, W3, 30.
la situation de ma boulance. Okay, looks good so far. Speed brakes armed. I'm just double checking the ILS frequency. And of course, sometimes Navigraph and Explain have different frequencies or of course, but here it's correct, so we can keep that. Okay, just a quick update for the meter. Okay, 1016 is still... approach speed is 143.
Again, 4387, contact tower 1190. Orbit tower,
lights are activated.
Sounds good.
So the airport is ahead, over there. Okay, caps one. Spoilers retracted. Spoilers armed. Auto brake is on low. Lights are activated. Speed brakes armed, 3000 is set.
Approach 15 left, 8000.
steps 25. Okay, you're on last mode. Okay, local as is alive. Okay, so there's an issue with the speed mode, but anyway, we do this manually.
Thank you.
Okay guys, so try to focus because I'm flying manually. So
approaching 1-6 left.
Right. Welcome to Doha. The landing rate is 212 feet per minute. Okay, there we are. Let's have a quick replay.
Thank you.
Okay, basically that was it. Thank you very much for watching. I really, really appreciate it, your support. I would be very happy when you give this video a thumbs up, and if not already done, subscribe to my channel. It was a pleasure to have you, and we're just going to the ramp and unload the aircraft, and then we are finally done. Thanks for watching, and see you until the next time. Vielen lieben Dank fürs Zuschauen und für eure Unterstützung. Wir rollen auch ganz schnell zum Gate. Ich verabschiede mich schon mal an dieser Stelle und freue mich schon, wenn wir beim nächsten Mal wieder gemeinsam ein neues Video starten und gegebenenfalls auch wieder von Doha und dann noch was Längeres. Einfach schauen, worauf wir Lust haben. Ich freue mich auf jeden Fall schon auf den nächsten Stream und wünsche euch einen schönen Abend. Vielen Dank fürs Zuschauen. Okay. So let's get the crew and equipment. Okay, this is off. Okay. Okay, once again, thanks for watching and see you again next time. Goodbye and good night.
Stop at 3,000, 2-4-8, manifold, and onboard, just type in 1.